Mr. Nagappan, for a investor with a moderate risk portfolio, someone who's just beginning off in commodities, ideally, and while this number may change from, you know, investor to investor, what is the portion of the portfolio you think he can devote for commodities?
I would normally suggest as roughly about 10% of the portfolio could be the on commodities, particularly for an average investor or a small investor. This is based on gold and silver bullion. I'm not looking into the other agricultural or other commodities. That way, I'm saying that there is a big opportunity available here, particularly with gold petal available. But just to add to what Mr. Muthappa was telling about the deliveries, there is a concern there. I myself started trading in commodities maybe about 12 years back, and because I was writing a book on commodity trading. And then I really wanted to take delivery of a commodity. And then I can tell you that nobody would try to take delivery of the commodity. I tried it very sincerely and very seriously, it was a problem. But now if you look at it, with GST coming in, I think taking delivery and the taxation issues, this is one nation, one tax, I think a lot of things are simplified and people feel very comfortable taking delivery. So that is a positive aspect of it. And second aspect, important aspect is that SEBI regulating it. It's coming under the regulation of SEBI.
Right.
There was a big, Mr. Muthappa was mentioning about the ADTO of 62,000 crores. It was in fact at one stage much higher than this also.
Yeah, I think we clocked in almost around 1,14,000 crores.
Yeah.
Single-sided. That's all. That means 2,28,000 crores in a single day.
Yeah.
Right.
So initial days people started coming in because of they thought that this was less regulated, unlike equity. And then they burnt their fingers by wrong advice, like he was mentioning, wrong tips or extra speculative trading. But what happened was once it has come under SEBI, now this gives us more comfortable to genuine traders, genuine investors, corporates, that it is well regulated and more regulation and coming in place. I think the quality of the investors or the traders will go up. I think that is something very important change which has happened, though the volumes are 60,000 crores. But it's a quality volume, now the volume will straight away, it will go up, I feel. Yeah.
So Mr. Sarvanabhavan, Mr. Nagappan said that 10% is a good number to start with, you know, what is your view?
Yeah, I do accept because whatever the risk is there, the same time rewards is there in this market. So better we can keep the risk and reward ratio is more, then we have to keep it in this much level. That whatever sir he said, 10% is good. I do accept that because we have seen people who come with lakh rupees margin. The same day they will take position of lakh rupees.
Hmm.
They don't even know what is the commodity, how it will impact on data, how the market movements is there. They never think about anything. They will simply go and blindly buy that product or buy the commodity or sell the commodity. So this is what we want to tell, don't do that blindly. So if you want to be in a pilot, you should go for a training, right? So like that, what we are telling MCX and members, they are arranging lot of training programs. Once you decide or you want to go into the markets, you should take the training. At least 30 days. Minimum 30 days. You can do the paper trading or whatever. But you should take training before entering into the market.
So Mr. Nagappan made a reference to, you know, a lot of investors also burning their fingers because of not properly not knowing what this whole thing is about. So what do you generally advise investors, first-time investors who come to you for trading in commodities?
See, we're supposed to do first a concept, learn, then earn. So first you understand what is the basics of commodities and how the prices impact it. So first you have to have enough margin. First you calculate what is the risk you are going to take for your investment. Then study about the commodities. Then watch, at least do the paper trading, then you start implementing in small quantities. Then as being a beginning to expert, then you can start doing more.
Okay. So Mr. Nagappan, what are generally some of the common myths about commodities, you know, either misconceptions or just myths that retail investors seem to have when it comes to commodities investing?
No, there is a perception that I would say that there are two types of different perceptions. One is that it is felt as generally it is very speculative. Second thing is there is a perception that it is highly risky and even riskier than stocks. The first part, I agree to some extent that the volatility is there, but then I think the risk element compared to stocks, it's very difficult to understand the common man psychology that why he feels commodities is much riskier than stocks, because probably because it is traded in futures, it was traded, you know, now options and now physical delivery is also possible. No commodity, the value of no commodity has become zero. But we have seen stocks trading at 2,500 rupees become zero. The stocks trading at 1,500 rupees become zero. It can never happen in commodities. So personally, if you ask me, I don't feel the commodity is as risky as stocks. But for the fact that most of the time we trade in derivatives. The derivatives in equities equally or much more this thing. So this is one perception which investors have, which probably prevents them in certain pockets of the country. It's not there everywhere. I think there are people who come out and trade. Majority of them trade in some pockets. Some pockets, this is a concern. I think if that is addressed well, more and more people will come into this market.
So I'd like to toss that question to Mr. Sarvanabhavan and Mr. Rajesh also. Mr. Sarvanabhavan, what are some of the common misconceptions that investors have about commodities?
Myth is nothing is there. Actually, the problem is understanding about the product. Or say if everyone wants a quick money nowadays. No, quick money is always not good, right? I think you know this is not a lottery or horse race. So we should understand first before, if we are not understanding, everything will be myth, right? So if we understand, if we can try to learn better way, so that too also not with the fake advisories or any other persons, third party. So you should learn with the proper persons, then it won't be a myth. Actually, it is not a myth actually. What you can understand once you enter the market, then you will understand.
Okay. Mr. Rajesh, so like in equities also commodities, investors use a mix of fundamentals as well as, you know, some of them follow the charts very closely. So what do you think is a more effective way for somebody to be good at commodities investing? Is it largely fundamentals or charts, or is it a mix of both? What works?
See, both will impact. See, if you, it's a fundamental coming, news will also impact, and technicals also is a bit. But you have to define what you are. You are an investor for long term or you are a trader. So if you are a short term trader, the daily trader, you don't want to look for the fundamentals. You have to understand the technicals only. So if I am looking for a short term, I'm assuming gold will go 1,000 points from like 6 months. Then I have to know only the fundamentals. So first you have to define who I am. I am a trader or investor. So accordingly you can use this, either technical or fundamental.
So what are some of the good sources where an investor can improve his fundamental knowledge on a particular commodity?
So at least they have to know about the price and the dollars or how it's impacting the price movements. Then they can read the more articles. Nowadays every apps are came. So they can learn about the particular commodity, what is impacting daily. Even nowadays news they are reading everywhere, but there are a lot of tools now in technology. So they can learn about the price impacts of the commodity.
Of course, you can get a lot of things in money control itself, right?
Thank you very
it's
much.
Like an encyclopedia, right?
Thank you very much. Mr. Nagappan, so what are some of the sources you would recommend where on how investors could improve their fundamental knowledge?
Normally, where I look at, I think a lot of online resources are available which are updated on a regular basis, particularly if you look at the exchange website. The kind of the research material they publish is amazing. If somebody has time to read all those things and go through that, they can understand the prices of gold for the last 400 years, how it has moved, what kind of volatility has happened. And there are a lot of research papers published by professors from IIM. For example, there is a research done on gold price and the correlation between the gold price and historic events done by a professor from IIM Kolikode from the period 1967 to 2007 or 2008. So last 30, 40 years he has analyzed it. So a lot of materials are available online. One has to have the time and look at it. But the primary source I would say will be the exchanges themselves. They publish, if you look at MCX website, there is a weekly report, there is a monthly report, there is a research specific topic related reports, which is not a general buy sell recommendation, but more of an in-depth analysis of the products. A lot of research has gone into that, I can tell you that. That will be a very good source for somebody to understand the product very well.
Now, if I understand, institutional investors too have been allowed to invest in commodities. How will this help change the market?
Yeah, the very good question. So if you look at these markets, I think we are on the 16th year where MCX basically began. See, now institutions coming in, banks, bank subsidiaries, and mutual funds coming in. See, all these basically create a depth of the market. See, I will tell you, more number of people coming in, ultimately, your open interest basically goes up, right? And for any trader or any investor, there should always be an ease of entry and exit. I think it's very, very important. And MCX gives it. So you should be able to buy or sell a particular commodity at any period of time. And if you just want to come out of the markets, you should be able to come out. So when we have the whole, the entire ecosystem trying to learn about commodities, trying to trade on commodities, trying to take deliveries, trying to hedge on commodities, basically the open interest goes up, the depth increases, and I think this is the ultimate thing to happen for a country like India. As I told you that we have a 65% of our population below the age of 35. And 50% of our population is below the age of 25, and India is the most youngest nation in the entire world. And we have a history of commodity trading. We were using options, sir. After independence, we were until these markets were banned in 1966. We were using options. It is not that, as Nagapan sir told, it is not that with commodity trading is new to us. You know, we have a long history. So with all these participants and banks, bank subsidiaries, institutions, mutual funds, and all these people coming inside, what happens is that an individual who actually doesn't have time to individually trade, he can always believe in the institutions. He can now mutual funds. He can use this channel of mutual funds who can invest on behalf of him. Right, that is what happens in the equity markets also. I think there is a lot of scope for these people to come in. Slowly, we are getting most of the institutions, mutual funds also into these markets, so that a common man, if he doesn't have time, so he can just park his money with that particular mutual funds, who will have fund managers who will study about that particular commodity and try and invest on behalf of them. I think that is the best thing SEBI has done.
Okay. Mr. Nagapan, what are the one or two qualities you think that is needed to succeed in commodities investing, that investors should try and develop?
Not only in commodities, most of the investment set. I feel that what is needed is, first of all, the patience to read and understand a lot of information related to the product or wherever we are going to invest. Because we are all so used to sign on the dotted lines, wherever we see into mark, we will attempt to sign. Or we are tempted to click on agree, I agree. So we should not do as far as commodities are concerned. We should understand what it is. We should read a lot, do a lot of homework. That is number one. And second thing is understand the regulation, understand how the product is structured, how the trading is done, the margining part. Don't over-leverage. I think that is very, very important. Most of them over-leverage. The problem in India is that, 98% don't invest in any of these commodities or stocks. 2% invest, 2% borrow and invest. They lose and they get out and become bad marketing advertisement for this. Whereas there is a lot of potential in this thing which has to be used. So I think this 98%, at least even if 10% gets converted into, they can benefit immensely, the country can benefit immensely. That's what I feel.
Thank you, Mr. Nagapan. Mr. Sarvanabhavan?
Once you decided to enter, then money management matters. Once you decided the money management, then you could be the successful investor. You must know how much I can lose. First, you have to decide. So what I can earn, then lose. That is matters. So what I am telling is be patient. Once you learned everything, then you go into depth. Until then, if you don't know swimming, don't get into the water. That's it.
Very good. Mr. Rajesh, you would like to add to that?
Yeah. See, being an investor or trader, first thing it impacts three things only time, money and knowledge. So money is ultimate, even an investor or trader you should have. Then knowledge. So if you have knowledge, you can. Then time. Whether you have enough time to understand market, you have time to trade, then you can be a trader. Or else, you can be an investor, you can just invest in mutual funds or anywhere. So this is the basic things they should have.
Well, that's all that we have time for now. Thank you, panelists, for those insights. And just to sum up for the last question, as to what really makes for good commodities investing, as the experts here have said that you need patience, you should not over-leverage yourself, And most importantly, you should have a rough idea of how much you're prepared to lose. So probably all these go towards making a good commodities investor. So thank you very much, panelists, and thank you, audience, for your patience and taking time out to be here on a Saturday.